Find the cube root of 30 up to 3 decimal places using Honor's method. We have equation x equals 30 raised to 1 by 3 will help us to find out cube root of 30. This equation, when taken cube on both sides, becomes x cube equals 30, which can be rewritten as x cube minus 30 equals 0. Let us consider f of x equals x cube minus 30, which can also be written as x cube plus 0x square plus 0x minus 30. We have specified coefficients of x square and x as 0 because this will be helpful while using synthetic division method. In the expression of f of x, we try for values x equals 0, 1, 2, etc. And we see that f of 0, f of 1, f of 2 and f of 3 are negative values, but f of 4 is positive. Thus, we identify that it is in this interval 3, 4 that root of f of x will lie. Since the lower bound of the interval is 3, we have 3 becomes the integral part of root of f of x. Root of f of x will be of the form 3 point d1, d2, d3, etc. And we wish to find out the digits d1, d2, d3, which are the digits that appear after decimal point. For that, the first step will be to diminish root of f of x by 3 using synthetic division method, so that we will get a new equation whose root will be of the form 0 point d1, d2, d3, etc. We write the coefficients of f of x, which is 1, 0, 0, minus 30, and here we diminish these coefficients by 3. In the first step, we get minus 3, which is the constant term. In the next step, we get 27, which becomes the coefficient of x. In the next step, we get 9, which becomes the coefficient of x square, and we have x cube will have coefficient which equals 1. Thus, we arrive at the transformed equation g1 of x equals x cube plus 9x square plus 27x minus 3 equals 0. We have this transformed equation which has been obtained from f of x after it has been diminished by 3 will have root of the form 0 point d1 d2 etc. You can confirm that root of g1 lies between 0 and 1 by using rule of Descartes. That is, you see that g1 of 0 is less than 0 and g1 of 1 is greater than 0, which guarantees that root of g1 will lie between 0 and 1. Now we have to find d1. For that, we wish to bring d1 as the integral part. So we look for equation whose root will be of the form 10 times 0 point d1 d2 etc. That is, we are searching for an equation whose root will be of the form d1 point d2 d3 etc. In order to obtain that equation, we will multiply this transformed equation using powers of 10. We will multiply x cube with 10 raised to 0. We will multiply x square with 10 raised to 1. We will multiply x with 10 square and we will multiply the constant term with 10 cube. Thus, we get the new equation f1 of x, which will have root of the form d1 point d2 d3 etc. f1 of x is given by x cube plus 90x square plus 2700x minus 3000 equals 0. In this expression of f1 of x, we try for values of x which will help us to find out interval in which root of f1 of x will lie. We have for values x equals 0 and x equals 1, f1 of x will be negative, and for x equals 2, we have f1 of 2 is greater than 0. This ensures that it is in this interval 1, 2 that root of f1 of x will lie. Since the lower bound of the interval is 1, we have the integral part of root of f1 will be 1. We have the root of f1 of x was already predicted as d1 point d2 d3 etc. Hence, we have the integral part d1 will be equal to 1. Our next step will be to find out d2. For that, we will diminish root of f1 of x by 1. So that we will get a transformed equation whose root will be of the form 0 point d2 d3 etc. We write the coefficients of f1 of x and we wish to diminish root of f1 of x by 1. In the first step, we will get minus 209, which becomes the constant term of the transformed equation. In the next step, we get 2883, which becomes the coefficient of x. In the next step, we get 93, which becomes the coefficient of x square, and we have coefficient of x cube will be equal to 1. Thus, we arrive at new transformed equation g2 of x. We have g2 of x will have root of the format 0 point d2 d3 etc. because this equation has been obtained from f1 of x after f1 of x has been diminished by 1. Since we wish to find out d2, we have to obtain an equation whose root will be of the form 10 times 0 point d2 d3 etc. That is, We are looking for an equation whose root will be of the form d2 point d3 d4 etc. In order to obtain that equation, we have to multiply this equation g2 of x using powers of 10. We will multiply 10 raised to 0 to x cube, 10 raised to 1 to x square, 10 square to x and 10 cube along with the constant term. Thus we arrive at equation f2 of x, which is of the form x cube plus 930x square plus 288300x minus 209000 equals 0. Now we have to identify the interval in which root of f2 of x will lie. For doing this, since we have the last two terms are very very large, we will have a shortcut method adopted here. Root of f2 of x will be approximately equal to constant term divided by coefficient of x. That is, root of f2 of x is approximately equal to absolute value of constant term upon coefficient of x. Thus here we have root of f2 of x will be approximately equal to 0.724. This value helps us to find out the interval in which root of f2 of x will lie. Since 0.724 lies between 0 and 1, we have root of f2 of x will lie between 0 and 1. Since the lower bound of the interval is 0, we have integral part of root of f2 of x will be 0. That is, our root d2 point d3 d4 etc. will take d2 equals 0, which gives us the information that root of f2 of x will be equal to 0.d3d4 etc. Since the integral part of root of f2 of x equals 0, even if we try to diminish the root of f2 of x by 0, no significant changes will occur. Therefore, the transformed equation will be exactly same as f2 of x. That is, we have transformed equation g3 of x coincides with f2 of x, since here we have integral part of root of f2 of x equals 0. Thus, transformed equation will have root 0.d3d4 itself. Since we wish to bring d3 to the integral part, we have to search for an equation whose root will be of the form 10 times 0.d3d4 etc. In order to obtain that equation, we have to multiply g3 of x using powers of x. That is, we have f3 of x equals 10 raised to 0 into x cube plus 930 multiplied to 10 raised to 1 into x square plus 288300 multiplied to 10 square times x plus 10 cube multiplied along with the constant term. Thus we have f3 of x obtained in this format. In order to identify the interval inside which root of f3 of x will lie, we will take the absolute value of constant term upon coefficient of x. We obtain this value as 7.2. Since 7.2 lies in the interval 7, 8, and since the lower bound of the interval is 7, we have integral part of root of f3 of x will be d3 equals 7. Now we have found d1 equals 1, d2 equals 0 and d3 equals 7. Since we have found up to 3 decimal places, we have the required root of f of x equals x cube minus 30 equals 0 will be 3.107.